my beautiful people. Thank you so much for tuning in. I'm so happy that you're here. In today's video, I'm going to talk about all the products that I use to remove my SPF, to remove my makeup. All of these are cruelty-free. Majority of these are Indian brands. And this video has all my cleansing oils, cleansing milks, micellar water, cleansing balms, everything that I absolutely love. I'll also talk about a few products that I absolutely hate. This is one of the most highly requested videos, and I'm so sorry it took me so long, but I really wanted to try out more products so that I could compile this all in one single video for you all. Now, in case you're new here, hi, my name's Preeti. I'm India's first cruelty-free beauty blogger. I talk about all things cruelty-free, which means products that are not tested on animals. I also talk about vegan beauty, lifestyle tips, sustainable life, and a lot more stuff. If this is the kind of content that you resonate with, then please subscribe to my YouTube channel and continue watching today's video. Initially, I thought of making just a cleansing balms video, but then I was like, you know what, let me just compile everything in one single video so that you can just have all the products that I absolutely love. Now, I'm sure you all already know a bunch of my favorite products because I do use them constantly on Instagram and I do talk about them quite a bit. This video is going to be really helpful for anybody that wants a variety of different products that are cruelty-free. But before I talk about these products, let's do a comment shout out. Today's comment is by Ashita and she says, love your recommendations so much. Now, it's only your channel that I go to for all hair care, body care and makeup. Thank you so much, Ashita. This honestly means the world to me. I'm so happy that I can have this one-stop shop for all recommendations for you all. I'm really trying to expand into different categories and I really want to get into clothing as well very, very soon. So stay tuned for that. And thank you all so much for all your love and support. I really appreciate it. Now, you all know the drill with skincare products and you need to sing it with me that beauty, skincare, hair care is very, very subjective. What might work for you might not work for me and vice versa. Whenever you watch any such videos online, please keep an open mind because even if you have the exact same skin type like mine, these products may not work for you. I have combination oily, acne prone skin and all of these work really well for me. Let's start with cleansing oils. The first one is the Claire's Gentle Black Deep Cleansing Oil. This is my second bottle. I absolutely love it since 2 years now. Now, what I absolutely love about this is that it doesn't sting my eyes. You guys, I have such sensitive eyes and this does not tingle, does not trouble, does not burn my eyes, and I absolutely love it. It removes all of that waterproof makeup, waterproof mascara so well. Even if you have the most drying liquid matte lipstick on your lips, this will remove it. I love it so much. It doesn't have any strong fragrances. It also emulsifies. So basically, after you apply it on your face to remove your makeup, you can add some water and it emulsifies into this milky texture and then you wash it off. Of course, go in with a face wash. I don't recommend using cleansing balms and cleansing oils and just cleaning your face after. Always use a face wash. Double cleanse. Double cleanse is really good for your skin. You would think that because it's an oil, it's going to be a little tacky on your skin, but it's not. It's not tacky, it's not sticky, it's not greasy, it doesn't leave an oily residue, it doesn't break my skin out. Man, this is some really, really good stuff. You can get this on Sublime Life. I have a code. I'm going to leave it on the screen. I'm a huge fan of Claire's because Claire's is vegan and cruelty-free. The next one is from Forever Earth. It's a cleansing oil that I absolutely loved when I had it. It's an empty. I don't have it on me. It's been almost a year since I emptied it. It is such a good product for removing makeup, for removing residue. It really works on removing all of that waterproof mascara, waterproof makeup. It did sting my eyes a bit, but then again, I have very sensitive eyes. So if you don't have very sensitive eyes, you can easily use it all over your eyes as well. It does remove waterproof lipsticks as well. It is a very good product. It's a homegrown brand. And a small indie business, and I really like it. I've used a lot of products from Forever Earth. They were all gifted to me by the brand and very good stuff. No added fragrances, very earthy fragrance because of all those ingredients. It's also quite budget friendly if you compare the prices with the other products that I'm going to be talking about. Little goes a long way with cleansing oils. You do not need to use a lot because they are oils after all and they break down makeup so well. Now, those two are the only cleansing oils that I absolutely love. I have tried a few. I didn't really enjoy them. These are the only ones that I absolutely love and recommend. Let's move on to bi-phase makeup removers and micellar waters that I strongly recommend. Let's start with the Lakme Absolute Bi-Phase Makeup Remover. This is one of the most easily found product in your drugstores, in your supermarkets, on Amazon, on Nykaa. This is so easy to find. It's also very cost effective. Little goes a long way. Now with this, you will need to use a cotton pad unlike your cleansing oil. So if you are into the whole eco-friendly bit where you don't want to use cotton pads and skip micellar waters and bi-phase makeup removers altogether. Now, Lakmé is cruelty-free. I get this quite a bit from you all. Lakmé is an Indian brand that does not test on animals because in India, animal testing is banned. Now, yes, the parent company does test on animals. However, that is the case even with NYX. It's owned by L'Oreal. L'Oreal tests on animals. It's also the case with Too Faced. Too Faced is owned by Estee Lauder. Estee Lauder tests on animals. So if you are into brands that have parent companies that don't test on animals, then maybe you can skip Lakmé altogether. But Lakmé is an Indian brand that only sells in India, not in China, where animal testing is required by law. The brand has also confirmed this on Instagram. I have an Instagram highlight where I've mentioned Lakmé CF status. Do check it out. I get this question quite a bit, but check out that highlight on my Instagram. It'll clear all of your questions. Now, since this is bi-phased, you will need to shake it and then apply it on a cotton pad and remove your makeup. Highly recommend this for all types of makeup, even the most strongest waterproof mascara and the most strongest waterproof lipstick. This gets the job done, man. I really like it and I highly recommend this. This has been my go-to product since years now. Of course, now I'm moving on to more cleansing balms and oils because I want to reduce cotton wastage. Now, this next one is a little expensive. This one's from Pixi and this is the Vitamin C Juice Cleanser. I'm almost done. This is my second bottle again. Absolutely love it. You need to dispense the product here with a cotton pad and then apply it all over your eyes, remove your makeup. Removes waterproof makeup really well, waterproof mascaras, waterproof lipsticks, removes SPF really well. The reason I like this is because it doesn't sting my eyes. It really cleans my skin. Like, it does such a good job, you guys. Like, even if I'm not splashing water, I can actually notice how clean my skin looks. And when I go in with a face wash, boom, all clean, everything. Very, very good stuff. It's not oily, it's not tacky. Yes, it's a little more expensive, like compared to all of these products, but I really, really love it. The next one is from Eclat Superior. This is their micellar water. This is an oil-infused cleansing water. Very, very good stuff if you want to remove SPF, if you want to remove basic makeup. However, this will fail you terribly if you're trying to remove any sort of waterproof mascara, waterproof eyeliner, waterproof matte lipsticks. This does not do the job. However, for everyday basic makeup and basic SPF removal, this is very, very good. If I'm not doing heavy makeup every single day and I'm not using waterproof mascara and waterproof lipsticks, I'm just going for like a nice tint, I will definitely use this because it removes makeup really well as SPF. Also, it's really easy to travel with. That's all for the micellar waters and bi-phase makeup removers. Let's talk about my cleansing milks that I absolutely love. Now, the first one is the deep cleanser. Oh, wait, it's the cleansing milk. I read this here. It's the cleansing milk from Lakmé. This is what it looks like. Super budget friendly, man. This is honestly so affordable. 140 bucks. You can get it on a sale. You can get it in your local supermarket. This does an excellent job in removing basic makeup as well as SPF. This doesn't really remove matte lipsticks that well. Also will not work on waterproof mascara, but for basic everyday makeup like Kajal, lip tint, BB cream, basic creamy lipsticks, basic bullet matte lipsticks, this does an amazing job. Of course, this will remove waterproof eyeliner. Like, when you apply it on your hand and you're removing swatches, it's very easy to remove it, right, with a cotton ball. But on the eyes, I feel like you need to rub a bit too much. Again, that's totally your call. I wouldn't recommend doing that. I think this is one of the most underrated products from Lakmé. It's also one of the oldest, if I'm not mistaken. Superb stuff. Highly recommend it. Now, this next one is from Himalaya. This is the Refreshing Cleansing Milk. This is for all skin types. I like this. It's really nice. I think anybody who's on a budget or for teenagers, especially those that don't wear heavy makeup, like heavy concealers, waterproof makeup, waterproof mascaras, waterproof matte lipsticks, this will work really well. This removes SPF really well. Very good for double cleansing. This will remove non-waterproof makeup. This also does a fairly decent job of removing all of that matte bullet lipstick residue on your lips. And I think this is great. Cleansing milks are really easy to work with. They're also very gentle on your skin. They are very lotion-like, very watery, and I really like this. In fact, this and the Lakmé one work pretty much the same. The next one is the cleansing milk from Organic Harvest. I'm almost done with this, you guys. This is some really good stuff. I like the fact that I can remove my waterproof lipsticks with this. Doesn't work on waterproof mascaras. In fact, none of these cleansing milks will work on waterproof mascaras. I love that all three of these can be used for removing SPF and makeup, lightweight makeup. I really like it. Pretty underrated, man. Cleansing milks are honestly pretty underrated. So these are the three cleansing milks. Highly recommend them. All of them smell pretty much the same. This will remove matte liquid lipsticks really well. All of these will remove non-waterproof makeup really well as SPF. Now that's all for the cleansing milks. Let's talk about cleansing creams. If you haven't used a cleansing cream, basically it's a very thick, creamy, balmy texture that works beautifully on removing makeup. So you don't have to use any cotton pads. You can just go in like a cleansing balm. It doesn't really emulsify or any of that. It just removes all of the makeup really, really well. And this is super for anybody that works with rhinestones, glitter makeup, a lot of false lashes, a lot of creative looks where you just want a thick cream to remove all of that residue instead of using a cleansing balm or a cleansing oil or a bi-phase makeup remover and whatnot. The first one is the Take It Off Cleansing Cream from PAC. This was sent to me by the brand initially, and then I went ahead and I bought almost 2-3 of them because this works so beautifully on removing glitter makeup. You all know when you have glitter chunks on your face, it's always gonna be there for weeks and weeks to come. Like, getting rid of glitter from your face is one of the most difficult tasks, right? But with a cleansing cream, it just gets so much easier. You can obviously just massage it in and then use a damp cloth or a cotton pad or whatever you're comfortable with to just remove it all off and then wash your face. That way you don't have glitter all over your face as you would with a cleansing balm, because you're gonna go all ham and then you have to use water to remove all of that. This breaks down makeup so well, and it's so easy to remove all of that glitter, you guys. You don't have glitter all over your face moving around, because this is not a very oily product. It's a thick cream. It's not oily where you have this residue all over your face where the glitter is constantly moving around where you're removing it off. Very, very good stuff. I'm also not surprised that PAC has a product like this, because they do have a wide range of glitter, so it only made sense to have a product that could remove glitters just like that. Now, this does not have any strong fragrances. It doesn't leave any residue. Very easy to wash off with water. It doesn't feel tacky on your skin. This literally feels like a moisturizer. Very good product, but I would still recommend you use a face wash. Always use a face wash after removing your makeup. You don't want any oily residue on your face. This is honestly such an underrated product. If you are a makeup artist, this is a product that you need to have in your vanity for removing all of that glitter makeup, festive makeup. And if you are somebody who loves festive makeup, loves to play with glitter, this is a cleansing cream that you must invest in. The next one is from Miss Claire from their Prestige range, and this is the Anti-Dust Daily Massage Cleansing Cream. Wow, that is a mouthful of words. This is what it looks like. It is a huge tub, you guys. Like, look at that. It's literally like 2/3 of my face. Huge tub. Looks like a tub of yogurt, but this is so good. Again, superb for anybody who does a lot of creative makeup, a lot of rhinestones, a lot of glitter, a lot of falsies. Superb stuff, man. This doesn't leave any oily residue. So this honestly works the same as a Take It Off Cleansing Cream from PAC. Both of these pretty much work the same, if I'm gonna be honest. And the prices are also pretty much right there. If you had to pick from both of these, I would recommend this, because this is a huge tub for the price that you pay. And a little goes a long way with both of these creams. Now let's talk about my favorite cleansing balms. I know you guys have been waiting for this. I wanted to keep this for the last segment to create some suspense. I'm not sure if it worked, but nevertheless, let's talk about my favorite one. So the first one is the Plum Cleansing Balm. This is a brand new one that I haven't even opened because I just emptied this one right here. Like, this is my second empty, and this is my third empty, and this is my fourth tub. This is such a good cleansing balm. Oh my god, it emulsifies so well. It removes waterproof makeup so well. It removes waterproof lipsticks. Does not sting my eye at all. Little goes a long way. It does feel a little heavy on the skin, but even if you have oily skin, you're anyway gonna double cleanse. You can't just remove your makeup with a cleansing balm and that's it. You have to double cleanse, because balms have a lot of oils. Very, very good stuff for removing all sorts of waterproof makeup. Emulsifies beautifully, turns into this beautiful milky texture, and then you can just wash it all off. If there's just one cleansing balm that you must get, it's this one. Literally, it's this one. All skin types, because you are gonna double cleanse. The next one is from Earth Rhythm, and this is the Bamboo Charcoal Cleansing Balm. This is their old packaging. I don't know if they still have this. This is how much I finished. This is my first tub. I bought this from Vanity Wagon. Really good stuff, you guys. I've heard that the new formulation has changed quite a bit and it's way too waxy and greasy. So we're just gonna wait till the brand relaunches the formulation. I did have a word with the brand team and they did inform me that they are gonna be launching this same formulation again. So I'm guessing you can just wait it out or get in touch with the team to help you understand if they have already launched it, the old formulation. This formulation is amazing. The new ones that they created had a more gray color and they were super waxy. not the best. That's what I've heard from all of you guys. You guys sent me photos on DMs on Instagram. You also told me that it's very, very waxy and doesn't really emulsify. So I'm sorry, you guys. I didn't know that they changed the formulation, but this stuff is really good. I'm definitely going to repurchase this after this is done because I like it. And I'm going to make sure I get the old formula. Like, I'm going to speak with the brand before I do, because this is so good. If you have oily skin, if you have combination skin, this works amazing. The charcoal in this really helps to remove all of that excess sebum. If you have dry skin, this could feel drying on your skin. I wouldn't recommend this for dry skin at all. Normal to oily combination skin, highly recommend this. It doesn't sting my eyes. It doesn't have any strong fragrances, and a little goes a long way. I love it, and I am just a little disappointed that they reformulated this and made it that waxy mess. I really hope they bring the old formula back super soon if they haven't already. The next one is the Bubble Farm Rose and Oats Cleanser, and this is what it looks like. I absolutely love this. I bought this months ago, you guys. I like the fact that this removes makeup really well. It doesn't sting my eyes. It has a very gentle fragrance, very balmy texture. I still have a little bit of product in this. Like, I've used up quite a bit. What I like about this is that it removes waterproof makeup really well. It emulsifies fairly decently. Now, the Plum Cleansing Balm emulsifies the best, and then the Earth Rhythm Bamboo Charcoal One old formula. This maybe comes on a number three because this doesn't emulsify that much. Another thing that I noticed about this is that over months and months, it stopped emulsifying. Like, when I newly got this, in the first 2-3 months, this emulsified really well. It did a very, very good job. But over the months, it became really waxy. Will I repurchase this? Maybe after I speak to the brand about this to understand why it stopped emulsifying towards the ending. But overall, this is a very thick cream, great for all skin types, but you will feel it a little on your skin while it's emulsifying as well. Not like the Earth Rhythm and Plum ones. You will definitely feel this on your skin, but it does an amazing job. It doesn't sting my eyes. It removes makeup really well. Just this bit about it just changing the texture, like, it didn't go rancid, it didn't go bad, it just stopped emulsifying, which is very strange. The next one is from Sapphire Botanics. It's a cleansing balm that I genuinely have enjoyed. It's an empty, I don't have it on me, but I'll leave a photo on the screen for you all. Now, the only reason why I didn't purchase it is because it doesn't emulsify. Literally, because it doesn't emulsify, I didn't buy it, because I love it when my cleansing balms emulsify. Now, if it doesn't emulsify, you are left with this really greasy mess on your face, which you can't remove with water and soap. You have to wipe it off with a damp cloth. And that is an extra step added to my overall makeup removal process that I don't enjoy. If you have dry to very dry skin and you're looking for a cleansing balm that is oily and moisturizing, that is a good product for you to invest in. It won't emulsify, but it does an amazing job on removing makeup. It also doesn't sting sensitive eyes. I really like it. It doesn't have any added fragrances. Very earthy, very natural aromas of all the ingredients used. Those were my all-time favorite cleansing balms. Let's talk about two cleansing balms that I absolutely hate. I am disappointed in them and I do not recommend them at all. The first one is the Raw Beauty Berry Much Cleansing Balm. I bought this. This is quite expensive. And my goodness, you guys, what a disappointment. Like, I've barely even used this. It's been months since I bought it, and that's all that I've used up. This initially smelled great, but over the months, like within 2 months itself, all that natural berry fragrance has gone. It smells really bad right now. Not just that, the day I bought this, it was so poorly packed, it came completely shattered. Like, it was broken, there was glass everywhere in the product. It was so horribly packed that I was genuinely shocked. Like, if you're sending a glass product, you need to be more careful, especially when you're shipping it to a different state altogether. I DM'd the brand and then they sent me another one, which reached me safe. So I didn't really want to throw any shade, but I want to let you guys know that there is a possibility that your products could end up being damaged in transit. Now, another thing about this is that it stings my eye like no other. I've only used this all over my face to remove makeup. I've been avoiding my eyes altogether, but ever since it has this weird fragrance, in just 2-3 months, I stopped using it altogether. And now it's also, I think, expired. So I haven't touched it at all since a month and a half now. Like, the stinging sensation stayed for hours. It was such a hot mess. My eyes were like swollen. And the first time I used it, I thought, okay, maybe it's just because I have very sensitive eyes. I gave it 2 more shots like an idiot. And this stung my eyes so bad. So I only kept using this all over my face just to use it up, because I spent my money on on this. While it says it's a gel to milk cleansing balm, there's nothing gel-like about this. It's a very thick texture. It also doesn't really emulsify that much. And within 2-3 months, it stopped emulsifying altogether. So now it just felt like wax on my skin. Wow, one of the most disappointing products. This is my first purchase from this brand, and I don't think I'm gonna make any more purchases. I don't know, I just had a very terrible delivery experience, terrible product experience, so I do not recommend this at all. And the last one is the Earth Rhythm Propolis Cleansing Balm. It came broken to me. This was gifted to me by the brand. Not just that, I haven't even used so much of this. Look at how oily and greasy it is, you guys. This literally feels like I'm putting butter on my face. It is such a terrible waxy. I can literally feel the oils on my hand. Oh my God, this is such a disgusting product. The first 3 times I used it and then I was like, no, this is not for me. I'm guessing the new bamboo and charcoal cleansing balm has a similar texture and that's why you guys didn't like it. This also didn't emulsify that well. I'm so disappointed with this. This was sent to me by the brand and I had extremely high hopes because after my bamboo and charcoal cleansing balm experience, I was like, hell yeah, I'm ready to try out some more cleansing balms, and boom, this happened. So I was just like, what is going on? How can a brand have such different formulations, like from a 10 on 10 to like a negative 100 on 10? This was such a disappointing product. It didn't sting my eyes. It removed the makeup pretty much okay, but so oily, so greasy. There's oil leaking all over every time you dip your finger into this or dip your spatula into this. Very greasy, very waxy. I don't recommend it at all. One of the worst cleansing balms that I have ever used. And there you have it, all of my favorite products for removing makeup and SPF from my skin for double cleansing. I always double cleanse after all of these products. I really hope you found this useful. If you enjoyed this video, please hit that like button so that I know you enjoyed watching it. And let me know in the comments if you've tried any of these products and what your experience was like. I would love to know. We all would love to know so that we can make the right purchase decisions when we choose the right products for our skin. I'm so happy that you guys are enjoying the series where I talk about my favorites in every category. I've done face washes, toners, night creams recently, under eye serums, I've done hair masks, shampoos. I've done so many of these videos and I'm so glad you enjoyed this. I will continue doing many more of such videos, and I have a lot of single brand videos coming up as well where I'm reviewing multiple products from a single brand, so stay tuned for that. Alright you guys, I'm gonna take your leave, but before I go, don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel and check out my previous videos right here. I will catch you all later, but till then, take care of yourself and stay hydrated. Bye!